YouTube. It's Walker Heckman here, back with another video. Today we're going to be taking a look at Eskimo's F1 Rocket Ice Auger. I absolutely love this auger, and I've got a lot of good things to say about it, so keep watching. Alright guys, so this is Eskimo's F1 Rocket Ice Auger. I got the 8-inch, and this I got with a pretty good deal. I paid $300 for this ice auger on sale, which comparing it to other brands, and especially some of the electric augers that are coming out, that is a very cheap auger. The main thing that sold me on buying this auger was that it's 22 pounds. I could probably lift this up with my pinky if I tied a string to it. This thing is easy to carry around. And it just makes life a lot easier out here on the ice. A 22 pound 8-inch gas auger. That's almost hard to wrap your head around, but it's here. Some simple things about the auger. Takes a simple 50-to-1 mix. It's very simple to operate. Got a simple on-off kill switch, a throttle trigger, pull start cable, and a choke. Those are the only mechanisms you gotta screw with to get this auger ripping holes through the ice for you. As far as starting goes, this thing starts on the first or second pull almost every time. And at the $300 price point, I don't know that many augers in that price point that could beat this thing in a speed race through the ice. This thing absolutely hauls. When I first bought this auger, I actually kind of screwed myself because I overprimed it and flooded it, and it wouldn't start for like 30 minutes, and it really ticked me off. I thought it was a piece of junk. And then I actually stumbled across another guy's review on this. I'll be sure to leave him in the description below. I can't remember his name off the top of my head. And he actually has owned it for a year or so, and he figured out that if you overprime it, it'll flood every time.
So what I'm talking about is you got your prime bulb right here, and you can see this clear gas line that goes into the carburetor. You can see the fuel in it, and you just want to push this prime bulb until you see fuel go almost to the carburetor, not into the carburetor. It's literally like one click of the prime bulb. If you do that, it starts up so ridiculously fast in cold weather every time.
So with that being said, we're gonna fire it up, punch a hole through this ice. This is nice, clear ice with a skiff of snow on top of it, and it's probably about 8 inches thick. Turn it on. I've already had it running today, so I'm not gonna choke it. Oh, almost went on the first pull. So, you probably couldn't tell because it's a video. I mean, you can't really time it, and I did a nice little transition in there. But this thing rips through the ice, especially for a $300 auger. Most people looking to buy this style of auger at this price are people that are honestly probably upgrading from a hand auger. Looking down at that hole, I'd actually say there's dang near 10-inch ice where I just punched that one. And I mean, it's just like that. In another guy's review I watched, he actually did complain about the fuel consumption, but I don't know if they've tweaked it slightly, because I've punched probably 100 holes with it on one tank of fuel, and there's still a little under a quarter tank left. So I'd say that's pretty good for fuel consumption. On another note, Eskimo has a wonderful warranty, and from some reviews that I've looked at online, they always cover their warranty. So that's something to keep in the back of your head too. Alright guys, so with that being said, this is an awesome auger. It's at a low price point. It's light, and it doesn't use that much fuel. If you're looking to pick this auger up, I'll leave the best place to get it in the description below. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Once my channel hits 1,000 subs, I'm giving away an ugly stick spinning combo, so that's gonna be epic. I can't wait for somebody to win that thing. If you have any questions about this auger, or about ice fishing, or about anything at all, make sure to leave them in the comments. I love interacting with you guys, and I answer every single comment. With that being said, make sure you hit that like button, and as always, keep it wild.